Hey guys, it's Annie Souter from Bay Club, and we're going to do another interval boot camp today. And today's boot camp is in the style of the 7-minute round. And during each 7-minute segment, you'll repeat the same exercises continually, like in a loop, until the 7 minutes are over. And for today's workout, I'm going to give you 2 moves for each 7-minute round, which means that you'll repeat them quite a few times during that 7 minutes. And you'll also rest as you need within those 7 minutes. Now, I've been doing a lot of high fitness, which is my live stream cardio I've been doing during this quarantine, and I don't think I can jump one more time. So for me, I'm not gonna add any additional cardio to this workout. However, what I would suggest for you, if you need to do some cardio, is between these 7-minute rounds that we do, and there will be 4, add some cardio, pause me, right? And add about 2.5 to 3 minutes of cardio, whether it be jumping jacks or burpees or some skaters or whatever it is, fast feet, intervals, whatever you've got, high knees. And then come back and do another 7-minute round if you need that. I just can't. I wish I could. I just can't. So what we're gonna use for today's workout is dumbbells, and I've kind of got them over here. I have the backpack out because if your dumbbells aren't heavy enough where 8 to 10 reps of something doesn't feel significant, you may want to throw on the backpack in addition. And you can either wear it in a front carry, right, with the backpack on the front, or you can wear it in a back carry. And it kind of just depends what's more comfortable for each move. You'll see what I mean. I am also going to use things that you may not have. So I'm gonna use a roller. I'm gonna use it for one of the first moves in the 7-minute round, but you don't need it. You can do it without the roller. I'm gonna use the wall and the roller together. You can do it by just doing it without the wall at all. You could also use one of those big stability fit balls, you know, Swiss balls, whatever you call them, instead of the roller for that. Go without. I'm also going to use a band for part of it, but you can do the same moves without the band. And for that, I'm going to use my coffee table as my bench. And I've talked about before in my other videos that this coffee table is the closest thing to the appropriate height for me. I find that my step stool is too low for me to hip thrust off of. My chairs are too high. And so this for me is a good height. It's kind of right under my knee height. And for some people, like, their sofas are a good height, or maybe even the sofa without the cushion on it, just using that edge works. So those are the things I'm gonna use today, and just modify with what you have, okay? And also modify the moves if you need to, if they feel weird or they don't feel right to you, you can always modify those, and I'll give you some options as we go. We ready? All right, my playlist is only 53 minutes, so if I need to restart it, we'll find that out, okay. Okay, we're gonna warm up first. We're gonna preview some of the moves that we're gonna do, and then we'll get started on those 7-minute rounds. Okay, let's start with an easy squat, right? Come down, come up. You're gonna try to keep your chest upright, so instead of folding forward like this, right, let's try to sit upright into it. And I've just got my feet a little wider than hips because that's what's comfortable for me. You can certainly take a more narrow, like here. All right, keep going, a couple more. All right, let's start with one of the moves that we're gonna do. We're gonna do a figure four today, right? So you're gonna kick this up and then you're gonna come down into a squat. So come on up, down. So same thing, try to keep the chest up as much as possible. And a lot of that depends on how long your legs are and almost how much flexion you have in your ankle. So some people will lean way more forward than others. All right, go back to that regular squat here. Try to get down to your lower depth, right, as you warm this up. One more. All right, let's do the other side, ready? Over you go. Come down. Nice, nice, nice. Take it steady, take it slow. Make sure that that bottom foot, the toes are pointing forward. Again, can tell this is my tighter side because my knee's a lot higher, right? Yeah. Do a couple more. All right, I'm gonna take my legs wide. I'm gonna reach side to side. Give me a little windmill here. Couple more like this. I'm gonna walk it out to an inchworm after this. I'm gonna get into a plank. So I'm gonna reach down from my toes. I'm gonna walk it out to a plank. I know you can't see me. Walk it back up. Roll all the way up. Let's do it again. Walk down. Walk it out. Go one more time. Roll that all the way up. I'm gonna come over here to my coffee table and I'm gonna push up off of it. Yep. All right. Now if you wanna put your knees down, do it on the floor with your knees down, grab a mat. Our single leg deadlifts, which are coming up today. So when we do them, we're going to do them with a weight in our hand. And I always like the weight in the opposite leg that is on the floor. So I like them like this, right? Yes, you can hold it in this other hand if that's better for you. So we're going to come down and come up. Now the key to this one, like we always talk about when you are doing any kind of hamstring move, is that you don't want to round your back, right? But yes, you can get a lot lower, right? Like you can probably get all the way down to the floor. But it's taking a lot of work out of this hamstring. So pull your shoulders back. And today, for what we're doing, there is no reason why you can't brace yourself against something, right? Hand on the wall, hand on something, in order to do the move and maybe use something a little heavier. One more time, this side. All right, we're gonna come out, we're gonna take a really wide leg squat, and we'll do the other side. Lean side to side, I'm gonna pick up my toes, stretch out all those inner thigh muscles, try to open up through the back here. All right, extend it a little more. All right, let's go into the other side. Single leg deadlift, yeah? Stretch out that hammy. Let's go a couple more. Alright, I'm gonna turn down my music for just a second. Alright, is there anything else I wanted to do? Yeah, one more thing. I want to practice our hip thrusts today because we're going to do those at the end. So I'm going to grab my mat, which is over here, and I'm going to put it on my bench or whatever you have just to give myself a little cushion. You might already have cushion on yours. All right. There we go. Move my plan and my timer out of the way. All right. So armpit level right there at the edge of whatever you're using. I'm going to bring it up and squeeze it. Your head is lifted right here. Come down, up and squeeze, big squeeze. All right, I want you to practice something for me, which is, I want you to come down, kind of narrow leg,
come up and separate your knees, right? So it's like an in and out. You're going to abduct at the top a little bit. Open it at the top, close it at the bottom. It's a very slight movement. But if you do have a mini band today, we're going to do that with the band on. And it's really going to kind of accentuate that. Go eight more counts, that is. I don't know if you can hear the music. Four, three, two. All right. Are you ready to go? All right, so remember, these are 7-minute rounds, but there's only two moves, so you're gonna be doing a lot. Don't be afraid to rest, right? Take a few breaths, especially between move A and move B. All right, move A, this time, we're gonna use that figure four that we just practiced, where I'm gonna use the wall and I'm gonna use my roller. However, you can do it right here without. And if I did, I might have a dumbbell and use it here. I might have the backpack on and do that. But I'm gonna use the roller and the wall so that I can get a little lower into it and be able to get out of it. So if you have a ball or a roller, you might wanna do that. You can always wear the backpack on the front if you're gonna use like a wall or something like that and you don't have anything to hold. Now, I think for the first one, I'm just gonna do body weight. I may or may not add a dumbbell to it for the second round. Okay, so we're gonna do 8 to 10 on one side, 8 to 10 on the other, right? And between 8 and 10, you're gonna make that decision between by how much weight you have, right? So if 8 feels like, wow, this is hard, that's what I'd prefer you to do. Go heavier and go for the lower reps than I would have you go lighter and go with more reps. However, you may just not have the equipment to feel like 8 is enough, in which case go to 10 or even 12 if you need to. All right, the second move is gonna be push-ups, right? Push-ups of whatever variety you like, and that's gonna be the same thing, 8 to 10, depending on what kind you're doing. And don't be afraid to take the reps down to 6, but anything fewer than 6, I would kind of take the weight off and do a few more reps. So, all right, we ready to go? All right, let me start with my timer. So I'm gonna grab this roller, I'm gonna put it on my back like this, right? And then I'm gonna come down like that. And on this first time I'm gonna do it, I'm just gonna use my body weight. Okay, we ready? All right, you set? All right, grab your dumbbell if you need it, grab the backpack if you need it. Here we go. Four. Here we go. So I'm going for 10 reps here. So this roller is allowing me to get a little closer to parallel than I probably could without the wall and the roller. Do one more on this side. All right, 10 on the other side. Get myself set. Get as low as you can, whether you have the wall or not. Got 3 more for me. One more. All right, push up time. Take a breath if you need it. Come down. This is where a good time to take a breath is. I'm gonna take a sip of water. That took me about 2 minutes. So it gives you an idea of how many times we might be going through this. Okay. I'm gonna add a little dumbbell to this. Okay. All right, get yourself set. Whenever you're ready, this is your 7 minutes, right? You don't have to worry about my 7 minutes. There we go. you doing? Other side. Isn't it amazing when you're not trying to elevate your heart rate, how much it elevates anyway? You feel this on both legs? I do. One's like a stretch and one's like a work, you know? How many I can do on my on my toes this time. Let's see. Some form there. Alright. Here we go. Should I take up the weight? I know your answer is yes. Okay. 5 more pounds, okay? Okay. Here we go. Oh yeah, there it is. Back massage isn't even helping. Four more for me. How are you doing? Ooh, yeah. Okay. I'm gonna bring my mat up because I don't know if I'm gonna make it all 10 on my toes. Let's find out. I want to make sure that every time I'm getting my face down, right, instead of taking like a quarter push-up like this, I'm going to absolutely do this and keep going. But that's not what's going to work my muscles, right? All right. I have under 30 seconds to go. So I'm going to do just a few on each side. Now I've got 15 seconds. I'm going to do like 3 on each side. Last 6 seconds. All right. Our first 7 minute round is done. Whew. A little out of breath, a little sweaty. All is good. Okay. Next. Ah, yes. All right. This one we're gonna flip it a little bit. The legs are gonna be like bilateral, meaning it's both sides at the same time, right? So we're gonna do a wide leg squat and we're gonna double pulse it. So it's gonna be like 1, 2 at the bottom. I'm gonna turn my toes out and I'm gonna grab something as heavy as I can. I might even do a dumbbell and a backpack on this because I only have one sort of heavy dumbbell. We'll see how it goes. And then you're gonna do single arm overhead presses. So the arms are single, but the legs are at the same time, right? So you're gonna give me 8 to 10 overhead presses with whatever you've got, right? That's the appropriate weight for that. All right, so you can do them with the elbow out, or you can do them with the elbow in, depending, like if you've got like a laundry detergent bottle, you'll probably want your elbow in. If you've got a dumbbell or something very stable and kind of balanced, you could certainly put your elbow out. It'll work the same area. You can always switch off between 8 to 10 on each side. I might kneel for that just so you can see me a little better. Okay, so my wide leg squat. I'm gonna put my backpack on my back. I'm gonna get my dumbbell. Got my big one here, which I'm gonna hold in a goblet hold, which means I'm gonna hold it by the ends like this. All right, so 8 to 10, 8 to 10, 8 to 10, 7 minutes. Let's go. Double pulse. One. Two more for me. Six. Ugh. Barely ate it, yeah? So that one was a 25 and then I wore the backpack. These are 20 each, so this is 40 pounds. No backpack for me on this one. All right. Make sure I don't drop all of myself. All right, here we go. Double ball, sorry. Might have to hold these down. There's like a lot of pressure on my hand. One more. Yeah. Alright. Overhead. I'm gonna start with this side first. More for me? Yeah. My heart rate is up, up. How about you? Take a quick sip of water before I go again. We've got about 3.5 minutes or so left in this round, which means we're now a little more than halfway through. Okay. I think I like my double dumbbells better. You want to feel this on your backside, like your backside's opening up. One more for me. Can you hear it? Breathe that air out. Starting to feel these, haven't you? One more. All right, I've got 40 more seconds or so. I don't know if I'm gonna try. Try six on each side, maybe. How's your timing going? You got about 20 seconds left. Four. All right. Whew. Sweaty. Heart rate's up. Okay. The next one, let's get up if you can, if you were even down. It's that single leg deadlift, right? So something to hold in that hand, right, when you come down. And feel free to brace yourself in order to use something heavier. Because I really want on this 8 to 10 rep thing for you to get the most out of it. So instead of kind of going lighter, because you're only going up to 8 or 10, try to go heavier, and if you need to, brace yourself if that weight's pulling you over and you're wobbling. So I may hold on to the wall on this. So we're gonna do 8 to 10, right, on each leg, and we're gonna follow that up by a hinged row. So you're gonna lean over, whatever you've got, the backpack, you know, two bottles or something like that, you're gonna pull this way. And I'm gonna alternate between a narrow row and a wider row. So I'm gonna go narrow and wider, just so I'm hitting multiple parts of my back. So we already did our chest with the push-ups, so I wanna hit the back here. We did shoulders just now with the overhead presses. So we're trying to take a tour of your upper body and also a tour of your legs, right? And then when we get to the core, it'll also be a tour of the core, so it really is truly full body. So that's why the method to this. Okay, so 10, 8 to 10 on the single legs, followed by narrow and wider rows depending on
what you have.
Okay. What do I want to use? I'm going to maybe start with this one. Go from there, see how that works for me. Certainly, if you have like a lighter band, and by lighter I mean like one of these plasticky ones, you certainly could put it on and that'll add some to it. So I might throw mine on. I might not even use this one. This is my, I don't know, it's called extra heavy. I would not call it extra heavy compared to what I use at the club, but it's extra heavy in this set, but I'm gonna use what I'm gonna call like light. Yeah, even though it's labeled heavy. Okay, all right. That's gonna be me. All right, you ready for this? And I'm just gonna leave the band on when I do my rows too, so we don't have to take it on and off. Okay. I'm stalling. I'm stalling partially for you, but mostly for me. Okay, here we go. All right. Here we go. I'm gonna hold on to my painting. So peel those shoulders back. And you really want to feel it on the leg that's standing, yeah? Oh yeah. Oh man. These are like bigger and not as desirable as my ones at the club, which is why they're here. All right. Go with my rose. Untwirl that and grab my other one of these. Okay. All right. 8 to 10 total, even if they're wide or narrow. Good. 6. Now, if you have really light ones, you could count a rep as both of them, right? All right, back into it. Should I try to go heavier? Let's try. Okay. That feels nice. It's not too hard. I don't feel like my form is suffering, but it definitely feels like it's working me a little more. Whew. You're telling this one is also working your core on both moves. That's intentional. Lots of core work here. I've got two more. How you doing? All right. Maybe I'll try the heavier ones. Deep breath. Oh yeah, these are heavy. Let's go. Here, yeah, that's kind of where it feels the most on those rows. but I do feel my back getting very warm. All right, we've got just under 3 minutes. Feels like another round full. Three more for me. How you doing? How's that back of the leg? Ooh. All right. Remember, when you lengthen hamstrings is when you tend to get sore, so don't be surprised. Tomorrow. Two more here for me. All right. Back. All right. Take a quick sip of water. Got about 1:10 left. Okay. By the time I start, I'm probably gonna have 1 minute left. I think I'm gonna try to do like 6 on each side, see how that goes. You've got about 33 seconds just for your own progress here. All right, 6 is a little short. I'm gonna do a couple rows just to fill out the rest of the time. I've got 10 seconds. Hip thrust. Okay, so I'm going to switch to my more intense band for this. We're going to do 3 different hip thrusts. So we're going to get set up just like we did in the warm-up. The first ones are going to be those ones where you were narrow and then you split your legs at the top. 10 of those, followed by 10 wide leg, like as wide as your legs go. Up, up, up 10 times, followed by 10 narrows. So really it's 30 reps, right? 30 squeezes. That is if you are unloaded, meaning that you just are using body weight or maybe body weight in a band. That's how many I would do. If you're gonna put your backpack on your hips or a dumbbell on your hips, you can absolutely take the reps down, right? Of each kind. For example, take it to 5 or 6 so that you're not killing yourself. It just depends on the load. But because I'm doing body weight, I'm doing more reps, 30 reps, right? 10, 10 wide, 10 narrow. Then you're gonna do a little, you're gonna do a pullover, right? So in that same position, you're gonna have to watch behind you. I might actually turn my table so that I have a little skinnier spot on it, because we're gonna reach over, pull over, and pull a dumbbell or two over from behind your head to your chest. So if I have it this way, I'm gonna hit the back of the table, but I have a thinner area of the table over here. So I'm gonna scoop that around. Let's see. Okay. Good to go. All right.
be over here. I'm gonna put my mat down. Maybe do it a little more so I'm on the edge of it. Okay, and then I'm gonna use my band. Now I've got a big, thick one, right? You use the heaviest band. If you've got a pack of these, you can always put two on at the same time. It'll make it like a harder band, right? All right, and then I've got a dumbbell to pull over. I think I'm gonna put my couple options here to see what I want in the moment, right? Okay, so let me demo it before I start the timer. So here, right, you're gonna come up, get that armpit here. The first ones are gonna be narrow to wide at the top, narrow to wide, right? Then set your feet wide, give me 10 like this, set your feet narrow, give me 10 like this, regardless of whether you have the band. Then you're gonna come down, pick up your dumbbell or whatever you've got, and you're gonna dip it below, pull it over. Dip it below and pull over. Now, if you've got some kind of thing where you absolutely can't reach over the top, like I almost did, just come on the floor, right? Scoot down on the floor, and then pull your dumbbell or whatever you've got, hold it the other way, like this, and then pull it over this way instead of like having it vertical. Okie doke. All right. Our last 7-minute round. Then we've got some core work and then we're good. I'm just gonna check the time. See how we're doing. Oh, so good. Not saying we won't run out of music, but the time for the workout is good. All right. Ready? I'm gonna put the timer over here so I can actually see it. Because once I get down, there's no need to get up. Ah! All right, let's go. 7 minutes, baby. Let's go. All right. Narrow to wide. Seven. All right, now I'm gonna set my feet wide and pump away here. Gonna come out halfway down. Make sure your head is lifted. Now these ones should be like a little relief when you go more narrow, right? Because you're not, especially if you have a band, right? You're not stretching the band. Big squeezes. All right. I'm gonna take my dumbbell. Pullovers for 10. All right, you can lay your head down for this one. Got two more. All right, bring it down. So during that round, I was like, is this heavy enough? In which case, I know I need to at least try the heavier one next time, right? Because you'll know when it's too heavy. You'll be like, wow, this feels like I'm going to hurt myself. And then you know. All right, I'm going in for round two. All right, here we go. Oh man, these are killer. And narrow. Gym when you can have dumbbells in 2 pound increments, 2.5 pound increments. Here I'm going like, gotta go up 5 pounds if I'm gonna go up. Alright, here we go. Oh my goodness, okay. All
not so much bringing it over, it's that deficit behind my head. So if you can really get that, I suggest you do it. I don't know how many that was, but I'm gonna do one more. Okay. We're about halfway through. How's this one going for you? It's kind of the end of the workout, so you're probably pretty fatigued. That's okay, just keep going. Wide legs, because that's what I feel the most. Band pull. So have you ever seen like a long band or like a, you know, one of those bands that you tie, just like a strip, right? Maybe the tube with handles, where you kind of reach to the side like this, and that focuses on your obliques. So we're gonna get in there. We're gonna simulate it by using something to hold out in front of your body, whether it's a dumbbell or, you know, something, right? Like a can.
something that's not too heavy. All you want to do is feel the squeeze, right? And you can definitely feel it with no weight at all, but adding just a little bit of weight will really accentuate it. So we're going to pull that. After that, what are we going to do? We're going to do bird dogs, but we're going to do them off the roller. For those of you who need a little more challenge on the bird dogs, I'll show you on the floor, and then I'll show you on the roller, and that'll add a little bit of difficulty. And then finally, we're going to do some plank work. That's going to take care of our whole core, like all the way around. Alrighty? Alright, so let me clear my area a little. So if you have one of those long bands or like a tube you can pull, and like a door handle, or you can even close, like in the tubes, you can close one side in the door and then just pull on the other side, that would be great. Otherwise, you can do what I'm going to do, which is use a dumbbell, or depending on how heavy your dumbbells are, something else. All right, so plant yourself, right? I'm gonna get like a nice kind of wide leg because that's how I feel the most stable. We're gonna come to the side and then pull right to the center. So here, here. Now you gotta make the resistance, yeah? Let's do a couple more. Now I just want you to put it down and think about where you feel it. I feel it greatly on this side and less so on this side, right? Kind of like here and a little bit down here. We're gonna do that same side again one more time. Now if you have something really light, feel free to keep going when I stop, right? Because I'm using 10 pounds, right? All right, let's do that again, same side. Got my arms fully extended. Maybe three more. One more time for me. All right. Let's do some bird dogs. Okay, I know we just did one side, so let's think about that, right? We're gonna do some bird dogs. We're gonna do the plank, and then we'll come back and do the whole thing again, but we're gonna concentrate on the other side. All right, so for this one, it's the same thing. So I'm gonna put the same side that I did that on, I'm gonna put that side knee down on here so that we're also doing the same side on here. All right, so put both of your knees down. Let me get this out of the way a little. Both of your knees down on it. Okay, so you're gonna leave that knee down on the side that we just worked, right, so that we're keeping track. Then you're gonna lift your opposite arm and leg. So you notice I have my toe down right now, and if you wanna pick your toe up, it's gonna make it even more challenging here. I'm shaking doing that. Some of you may not, this may not be a good idea, right? In which case, put your mat down, right? And do the same thing right here. And another thing you can do is, like, let's say I had that peanut butter jar, right? You can double pulse this with a very light weight to keep the stability of the move, but add some difficulty without going, or if you don't have something like this. All right, let's do it. Get yourself up. All right, so we're gonna do one side here. So I'm gonna start with my toe down. I'm just gonna come down and tap it, come right back up into this side. I'm gonna do a few to get myself stable and comfortable, and then I'm gonna try to lift that toe up. All right, we ready? Give it a try. So if you are doing any of the other variations, just keep going. I'm gonna try one more on this side. No toe down. Unstable knee. Alright. Finally, we're gonna hold a plank. Tiger on for this, just so we know how long we're doing it, so I keep it even both times. All right, I'm gonna hold the forearm plank. You can certainly hold a full arm plank, which should be here. All right, we ready? Get down into it. Oops. All right, hold, hold, hold. So I want you to, first of all, give your glutes a squeeze.
You don't have to keep that contraction the whole time. Just squeeze them. That'll let me know that you're not like this, right? And push your chest down. Breathe, breathe, breathe. We're about 30 seconds into it. Readjust your feet if you need to. Squeeze your glutes in order to get your legs back in alignment. I feel like my CD is about to end, do you? We got 15 seconds more. Seven. See? No more music. Four, three, two, done. That was a minute hold. And you can always hold it on your knees, especially since we're gonna do that one more time, the whole thing, other side, for the first two moves. Let me put some music back on. Take a breath. All right, let's put on, how about this one? There we go. All right, other side, you ready? Ah, roller. Roller's done with the workout. All right, here we go. Other side. Unlock your knees and like don't let your shoulders come up like that, right? We did two sets of 10-ish on the other side, so we're gonna do the same. Give your arms a rest. Hopefully you're feeling it here. All obliques. Ready? Right. Hold it. I've got two more. Oh. All right, back to the roller or the floor. All right, get yourself set. We'll use the actual floor here. Okay, toe down to start. Do two more like this, and then I'm going to try to lift my toe. Now, this is my side that's a little wonky, so we'll see how it goes. Might have to stay with this option here. All right, let's find out. All right, move my knee. Everything's holding on really tight, but it's quite happening. It really gives you some information as to how your core stability is, and mine is on this side not good. I'm gonna do a couple more. Ooh. One more for me. Oh. Oh, man. I cannot wait until the massage place is open again. All right. Plank. And then we're done. We'll stretch. Ready? I'm going to take a sip of water before we go. Hold on. Okay. plank hold and then we're finished. High five. We got it. We're here. Fist pump. Then a high five. Elbow. Huh. All right. Let's go. All right. All the cues as before. A little squeeze of your glutes. Push your chest down. Shoulders to the ceiling. Separate your arms. Look out in front of your hands. Maybe look at your manicure or lack thereof. Halfway through. Lay on our back and open up our spine a little. So let's do that. Come on down. Let's grab your knees. Roll and this way first. That should get you a good start here. All right, figure four that. I know you don't want to hear that again. I don't want to hear those words again. But once you figure four, let's pull it in. You can straighten this leg or you can bend it. I'm gonna bend it and actually grab my shin here. And then we're gonna roll this whole thing to the side. So I'm gonna go so this shoe goes down onto the ground. So like you're a little bit pretzely here. And I'm gonna look away. Take this arm up overhead. Give you a nice full stretch. Alright. Roll that guy back to center, both feet on the ground. And I just want you to neutralize your spine, meaning just kind of let it, push it down to the mat first, how's that? And then let it go a little bit. Let that tension go. And just plant your feet directly on the ground. And just a couple breaths here. Soles of the feet together, let your knees bend open. All right, let's figure four on the other side. Here, open, pull it in. I'm gonna grab my shin. Take this whole thing down. I'm gonna look the other way. Alright, take that arm, add butt stretch. Alright, back center, one more time in that kind of neutral spine position. Alright, we're gonna bridge up a little bit. So it'd be nice to have your feet on the floor or somewhere where you have a little bit of grip. So come up like this. Come on down. Alright, let's pick that up a level. So why don't you take go up on your elbows and then come up. It'll give you a nice shoulder stretch. And if you're up for it today, what about if we did a bridge like this where you push all the way up? Right? Here. So that's not your jam, don't worry, just stay with this, right? Give a nice glute squeeze, and then you can alternate it with some of these pull-ins, right? And it'll give you some nice back stretches here. Don't worry about doing fancy stuff. Let's do that one more time if you're up for it. Either the bridge to the knee in,
or give me this full. Ready?
Use your glutes.
All the way down. Roll up to sitting. All right, one leg in, one leg out. Go for that hamstring. Ooh, yeah. Get up here, wiggle around, a little sunbather, chest, switch to side, reach up again. Either. All right, we're gonna stand up. So tuck those feet in, maybe you push it over, touch the ground, roll all the way up. And stretch my quads a little. We did something hard. Too deep breaths. One more time. There's like a, I know you can't see, but there's like a giant deer. Like right behind. Like I'm looking out through my patio and there's like a giant deer right there. So, see if I can get a picture and post it. All right, have a good day, you guys.